Next team we're going to talk about is River Brown's team.
What the
Chicago,
hell?
The Chicago Bulls. They finished with the 11th seed last year, 22-43. And this might be a hot take, but for me, I'm excited for
Patrick Willis. Why didn't when Nets popped up, why didn't you say Jack Bartek's team? Why did you only say my name?
Because I felt like it, man. I do That's what ridiculous. I feel like. But I'm excited for Patrick Williams. Before I get into him, I'm going to talk about their moves. Porter picked up the option, of course, because nobody was going to pay him that amount of money anywhere else. Denzel Valentine's option was picked up. They signed Garrett Temple, Devon Dotson from Kansas, who I like his game, even though he's an undersized point guard. They lost Chris Dunn, Shaquille Harrison. And the biggest move of them all, they got Billy Donovan to be their coach, which, you know, if he pans out, the Bulls have a high ceiling. But a guy I want to talk about right now is Patrick Williams, drafted fourth overall. On draft night, it was looked at as a reach. I thought it was a reach. I thought it was a bad pick. But studying him, looking at the film, seeing what people are saying around the league about him, seeing what people that I respect are saying about him, I think he's going to shock a lot of people. You know, Patrick Williams, he has a size. He's an elite defender. People just question his offensive game. But I think he's more developed offensively than people give him credit for. And just a guy who talks basketball, Rashad Phillips, he talked about Patrick Williams shocking people. Then Pooh Jeter doubled down on it on Twitter. And Devin Williams, one of the most renowned basketball trainers, said that, yo, these guys told me that Patrick Williams was like that. And he trusts these guys. So, and if Devin Williams says that Patrick Williams is going to be good and don't sleep on him, I'm not going to sleep on him. I'm going to take his word for it because he's a great basketball mind. So I think Patrick Williams is going to shock a lot of people. And now you have a lineup of Kobe White, Zach LaVine, Patrick Williams, Lauri Markkanen, and Wendell Carter Jr. I think this team can shock a lot of people coming into the regular season.
Yeah, I actually agree. And I like Patrick Williams a lot. I thought that they reached a little bit on where they got him, but you look at where he's coming from. Florida State, Leonard Hamilton runs a spectacular program there. Even if they're not in those top teams every year, he's a great head coach, and he's developing talent and making sure they're taught the right way there. Players in the last few years that he's brought to the NBA, Dwayne Bacon, Malik Beasley, John Isaac, all guys who have shown some serious upside. So,
and Jack, not to cut you off, but even I'm going to cut you off. Devin Vassell looks polished already.
Yeah. So I'm high on Florida State guys in general. I'm high on Leonard Hamilton and what he teaches there. He's always competing in a very tough ACC. So I like that Patrick Williams move as much as I wasn't a fan of where they got him. You get your guy where you pick, and that's been shown amongst any sport. If you think you have your guy, it doesn't matter if you're reaching, you go and get him. And again, I don't want to overreact to off-season tapes, but from what I've seen of Patrick Williams this offseason against other NBA players in pickup games, he looks legit. And, you know, I'm excited for this Bulls team. I'm echoing what Joel is saying. I put them in that same boat as the Hornets. Immediately, first thing, getting Jim Boylan out is a win. You automatically made your franchise better by getting rid of him. He was the worst coach in the league, and you got rid of that terrible ownership group and front office. You bring in Arturis Karnisovas and bring in Mark Eversley at the GM spot. You automatically have made yourself a better franchise in general. I spoke very highly of Lauri Markkanen when we were talking about most improved player race. He's my guy. And I think you have a lot of good young talent on this team. Kobe White, Zach LaVine, Wendell Carter Jr., Lauri Markkanen, even a guy like Tomas Satoransky, Patrick Williams. Like, there are some names on this team that I am very excited to see in a new system. So I think they could surprise some people. I have them in that same bubble with the Hornets as a team that I think can surprise a bunch of people, depending on what Billy Donovan does coming in here.
Yeah, and Chandler Hutchinson, he's a pretty good player too.
Ryan Arcidiacono is still there, I believe, too, right?
Mm-hmm. I was going to mention him. I just don't know how to say his last name. So I'm not going to miss him. So what are your thoughts on this, River Brown?
Well, you're done cutting me off. I can, you know, chop it up. No, you know, I don't like to watch off-season tape because I feel like people, you know, exaggerate it a little too much. People, like, drag it a little too much. But I'm glad you guys just told me about the Patrick Williams tape because I was extremely heated on draft night when we went above and beyond to pick that guy at four. But I do agree with Jack in the sense where Leonard Hamilton is great. And you forgot to mention guys like Malik Beasley and Dwayne Bacon. Those are guys who also played under him at Florida State. That, they're a top 25 team almost every year. They produce talent. He knows what he's doing. This team, you know, I had questions. You know, last year I wanted Cam. The year before that I wanted Michael Porter Jr. So I've been raving about getting a wing. We needed a wing for a really long time. And Otto Porter Jr., he'll be off the books next year. So I'm hoping Patrick Williams gets to start this year so we can see how the young guy is. We can develop him faster. Kobe White is going to be an interesting guy. I feel like he's more of a scorer than playmaker, and that's going to be intriguing to see because him and Zach are going to be in the same court together. And Zach is a playmaker, but he's our number one scorer too. So that's asking a lot from him. But I want to see the transition Lauri makes and Wendell. But if we're just healthy, we can definitely be in that play-in type. We can be like the Charlotte Hornets. I see us being as low as 12, 13, but I also see us as high as 9, 10. I think we could definitely be in the play-in. My situation is the bench. Thomas Santoranci is good, but he's not great. Thaddeus Young, he's kind of falling off in age. Denzel Valentine, he's not good. Let's just cut it dry. Let's just call it with it. Chandler Hutchinson, he's young. Let's see how he is. Ryan Arson, that guy. Ryan A, he's a steady point guard, Villanova point guard. So, you know, he's going to do everything right. He's going to do everything the right way. So he's a good player. But Billy Donovan, I think the front office and Billy Donovan, I think that was the biggest thing. Jim Boelow would not stress this enough. His quote was, Giannis was easy to stop and then started Chris Dunn on him to play the game. That was the worst thing I've ever seen in my life, and I will never forget that. So I'm glad he's out of here. The front office was making terrible moves ever since they traded Jimmy Butler. I'm glad they're done. We have the new guys. I'm excited in the direction we're going in. I hope Billy Donovan is the guy, and I'm just hoping we keep Zach, and I hope we be great, man. That's it, man. That's it.
And a guy that's not getting mentioned either is Thaddeus Young. He's still on the team, and he's a pretty good role player. He started on the Nets for a couple, like a year or two. I'm not sure. But, yeah, you look at this lineup. Kobe White, Zach LaVine, Otto Porter, Lauri, Wendell off the bench. If he comes off the bench, Patrick Williams, Satoransky, Hutchinson, Garrett Temple.
Daniel Gafford gets burned, too. He's good.
Thad Young. Valentine, Gafford. I mean, I mentioned Gafford, but yeah, I mean, they got a lot of young guys. In my opinion, I think they're going to finish with the 11th seed. I can see them finishing as high as 8 or as low as 11 or 12. And in my opinion, if they finish low, it's not even that bad of a thing because this draft is heavy. You can get your point guard in the future. If you're lucky enough, you get Cade, or if you get unlucky enough, you still get lucky by getting Jalen Suggs. And now you have that point guard of the future and Jalen Suggs to pair up with this talented roster. Their future will look extremely bright. So, yeah, I could see them finishing 8th, but I think they'll finish 11th.
And I was watching – I don't know if you've seen it, Jack. The G League stats came out for the first scrimmage, and Jonathan Kuminga and Jalen Green, they obviously showed out. And I'm under the impression where if we get those two guys, or we get Cade Cunningham, we get Jalen Suggs, or even we let Wendell Carter go and get Evan Mobley, I'm fine with any of those. Even Terrence Clark, who's looking like he can be a guy, I'm fine with any of those guys. I'm okay with that. I feel like this is the direction. I feel like Kobe White is going to be our guy. Patrick Williams, Lauri, I feel like we're going to bank on him a little more. I don't think Wendell's going to stay for too long, but I think those are the core group, and Zach, too, a little bit. But I'm fine with any of those guys. I'm hoping if we don't get in the play-in, we get one of those guys. So I'm good with all that. But I think Kobe White, Zach, they're probably going to start Otto Porter, Lauri, and Wendell. They're probably going to roll out that lineup. And I hope we see the improvement from Kobe White because we know he can score. And he can get hot at any moment. But can he be that playmaking point guard that we need him to be?
Yeah, and I trust Billy Donovan. Obviously, I trust him more than Jim Boylan, but I trust him as a coach to get a lot out of that young talent that you guys have. So, you mentioned Thad Young and Garrett Temple, two former Nets who I like bringing in some veteran leadership and, you know, showing these guys the ropes. And another great thing for the Bulls in this new NBA system, you don't have to tank to get the number one pick. Just get a ping pong ball to bounce your way. And you guys are going to be a top three pick. Personally, I could see the Bulls finishing around 9, maybe 8 in a dream scenario, or down at 13. I have them at 12. I think they're another team like the Hornets, could burst some people's bubbles and could sneak into that play-in game at 10. But I just don't know that they're there yet. But another team I think is headed in the right direction. I like what I'm seeing out of them as a franchise overall. So I think this is going to be the turnaround after pretty much 5 years of nothing good. So they're headed in the right direction. Well, 2015 was the last year of Tom Thibodeau, no?
Yeah, but we made the playoffs 2016. Don't do that to us.
I feel like ever since Tom Thibodeau left, it's been kind of a decline.
Yeah.
How obviously the last like 2 years it's been off a cliff, but
yeah,
I like the direction the Bulls are headed in right now.
We were going to upset Boston 1 year if Rondo did not get hurt. I'm telling you, the Isaiah Thomas year.